Welcome back, YouTube. Thought I'd do a little Ukraine update for everybody as a palate cleanser. The little kids dying. How about fighting for one's freedom and fighting for your kids' future against the bullies who would stick a gun in your face and tell you, you gotta learn this language. You gotta follow this dogma. The only way is the Russian way, and we're gonna force it. That's fascinating, Woke Patriot. Woke Patriot pointing out that Zelensky invited Xi Jinping to Ukraine. What building in Kyiv does Zelensky store his nutsack in? That's what I want to know. It's probably top secret because the Russians will be bombing it. It's just a big, it's like a double dome somewhere. It's just two big old domes. Everyone thinks it holds grain. No, that's Zelensky's nutsack. Invites Xi Jinping. Drone targets Russian truck carrying ammunition to Bakhmut. Russians flee, abandoning the truck. Don't worry, folks. These videos are censored. You will not see any dead bodies. Xi will probably just ignore it for now. He'll put that one in his back pocket. He's not going to respond to it right now. Because everyone's waiting to see how Russia handles this counterattack. Then they're gonna make their move. Everyone's waiting on the counterattack. Boy, super! Oh man, those guys were seconds away from death. Seconds away from death. He just farted. Good one, kiddo. Run, motherfucker, run, dude, run. I'm getting the fuck out of here. One thing I wanted to point out is how, I mean, this guy has to be hauling. He's got to have the pedal to the metal, flooring it, right? And the drone just keeping right up. These drones are really fast. Look at that shit, dude. He's got to be doing 60, 70, 80. He's got to be hitting that. He finally starts, you know, outrunning the drone, but maybe when he hits like 80 or 90. I don't know. Those drones are really quick. Widespread assumption that Xi and Putin are united or friendly seems unsupported to me. I mean, it's very clear to me that Xi Jinping finds this to be an annoyance, right? But, you know, they're like, the oil is so cheap from Russia, you know? I mean, you gotta placate a little bit. You know, honestly, China really hasn't even hooked up Russia with any of their good shit. You know, they've just kind of let smugglers, you know, get away with it. Davey was pointing this out. We should talk about this real quick. Because this does have to do, you know, serendipity. It's connected to Ukraine through NATO. Trump hush money, New York indictment. Okay, and I guess we'll cover Trump, too, once we're done with this. The Turkish parliament just voted to approve Finland's NATO membership application. 276 MPs voted for it. Zero were against. All 30 NATO member states have now approved it. Finland is certain to join. NATO expansion just became a fact. Thanks, Putin. Employee of the motherfucking year, dude. Employee of the decade. Fucking NATO progress has been gathering cobwebs for decades, and all it took was one motivated bald man with cancer to come on in and kick some ass. It's like a twisted Breaking Bad. Man, Putin, you gotta love it. Man, what a hard-working employee for NATO. Such a hard-working employee for NATO. Getting it done, man. He saw stagnation, and he said, I'm a man of action. I'm gonna help NATO. This organization seems to be getting a lot of shit. I'm gonna legitimize it. And you know what? We're going to help expand it too. Can someone please send this man a fucking plaque? Attach a little Nobel Peace Prize to that bastard? Here you go, Pooty Poot. You did such a good job. Let's take a look at this Trump news. So these cowards are getting him on the fucking blowjob money. Let's emoluments clause? What's that? Never heard of it. All the crimes and money and fucking... The guy made billions of dollars in office? Nope, never heard of that. I don't even know what you're talking about. Huh? What? Money? Who? Trump? Huh? Never heard of it. Don't even know what you're talking about. Blowjob money before he was president. Okay, yeah, he wasn't even president at the time. And it's like sex stuff. Okay, sure, whatever. Can we slap him on the wrist for that one? All right, let's get the update. Russia takes Bakhmut. Do we all call Artemivsk? No. We don't even call Kyiv Kiev anymore. We call it Kyiv. Do the blowjob dance, Trump. Let me see some blowjob dancing. Oh my God, fucking Peter Griffin over here with the motherfucking news, y'all.
Oh my God, who the hell cares?
I'm sorry. I'm sure this guy's a respected journalist. I am the asshole. I'm sorry, Balsamo. I'm sure you're a family man and a well-respected journalist. Let's get back to it.
I'm the U.S. law enforcement editor for the Associated Press, and we have breaking news.
They're getting them in
Former
young.
President Donald Trump has been indicted by a grand jury in New York City in a hush money scheme in which it's alleged he paid money to women who claim they had extramarital sexual encounters with him. This is an unprecedented moment in history. It is the first time a criminal charge has been brought against a former U.S. president. This case goes back to the 2016 presidential election when it's alleged that Donald Trump and his allies paid hush money to porn actress Stormy Daniels in connection with her allegations that she had an extramarital affair with Donald Trump.
Didn't she also, didn't these two fuck as well? Didn't she like tweet, like when these two were like, they had their tiff, she was all like tweeting? Because this is Michael Avenatti, who like had to divorce his wife because he was like, there was a scandal there. He was all like pretending to run for president and everything. But didn't they have like a little sex thing going on as well?
It's alleged that Trump and his allies, including his former lawyer, Michael Cohen, made a $130,000 payment to Ms.
And it's so wild to me. I mean, Michael Cohen is ready to squawk. He's ready to give them anything that they want. You know what I mean? He's ready to go. He's ready to squawk, 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 and talk, talk, talk. And nobody's asking him the right questions. They don't want to know. They don't want to fucking know. Putin just created himself an 800-mile border with NATO. Yeah, he's getting now we need double buffers. Now we need more buffers. We need buffers on top of the buffers, Clutch Cargo. I'm just gonna take this whole hemisphere as a buffer.
Daniels in order to keep her quiet about the alleged encounter. This is significant because it's the first time Donald Trump faces criminal charges in connection with investigations into his conduct. Those investigations shadowed his presidency through 2016 and beyond, and he faces increasing legal scrutiny in several other investigations, including one being conducted by the district attorney in Fulton County, Georgia, and a separate Justice Department investigation being led by a special counsel looking at his retention of classified records at his home in Mar-a-Lago in Florida and his efforts to overturn the 2020 presidential election. This situation is still developing and we'll continue to learn more in the coming days, weeks, and months.
Hey, you know what? Big props to what's his name here? Mike Balsamo. I hope you're a good sport. I'm not making fat jokes. You're not that fat, dude. This is like clearly just your build. You just look a lot like Peter fucking Griffin, bro. You're like rocking the Griffin look. I'm sorry. I hope you have a good sense of humor, Mike. You seem like a really nice fella. You know, you're hard work. You seem like a hardworking dude. Okay, so when is this son of a bitch that's alive in front of some building? It's live, guys. Fucking bro, whoa! The protesters have all gone home. They don't give a shit. There's only a couple hundred diehards anyway.
Oh, yeah, right. I'm not going to that They're all the feds. They're going to get me. They're going to add me to the no-fly list.
All right, there you go. That's a door. That's the entrance to the district attorney office. Okay, wow, great. Great journalism, guys. All right, fucking wake me when the fucking Cheeto is literally in handcuffs. Fucking wake me. What if he likes balsamic vinegar? I was going to make those jokes, but those are fat jokes. I'm not going to do that to my boy Peter Griffin. It's just a whole lot of fucking Ukrainian kicking Russian ass today, folks. I don't have a lot of substance for you. We'll do a map analysis video to close it out, but I just wanted to show you some of these amazing videos that have been posted in the Discord. It's !! Discord if you want to join. Lots of amazing stuff. Thank you, Kim. Thank you, Woke Patriot. Thank you, Davey. Thank you, everybody else that contributes. When do you think there'll be a Ukrainian offensive? Any day now. Any day now. We've seen, and I have video of that from Davey, who was nice enough to post it. But the congregations are starting, the armor buildups, the troop buildups. I think the weather is, you know, things are dry. The earth is getting, you know, nice and firm. So I think any day now. Lots of great stuff we can't show. The sniper videos, I wish I could show the sniper videos. Can't show those. Some of these videos are absolutely breathtaking in not in a good way. In a like, I can't believe Russia is throwing their human treasure away like this, kind of way. Just in a shocking display of arrogance and what it looks like, what it really looks like to bring a knife to a gunfight. You know what I mean? And the deadly and dangerous repercussions of coming into a battle half cocked. Yeah, crazy. Welcome back, Line Cut. Here's a classic tank fight using the building as cover. You know, he's ready to dip in there at any moment. He sees something coming his way. You know, throwing shots like a mile away. Look at that son of a bitch, dude. Black, dude. Black. So, you know, Davey, they have it really fortified. They got that entire path to Melitopol really fortified. What if they went in? What if they went in and just used this counteroffensive to feint into Melitopol, but take the rest of the Donbass? It's the Donbass that doesn't have the whole Donbass region is the region that doesn't, that has the limited amount of troops. It would make sense to go to Crimea, but have you seen the they have like a half a dozen platoons like right there on the border, and then like a bunch more right in Melitopol. Like, it's like, that's a slog, man. It might make sense to take the north. Yeah. Everyone's talking about this. They've had a lot of time to prep. Hippie herpes. Oh my god. The Twitch names just get more and more disgusting. Russia has been about to take Bakhmut for about 2 months now. I'm not going to sit here and try to predict what's happening in Bakhmut anymore. Clearly Ukraine has a better idea of what they're up against, because most people are like, they look at the map and they're like, this really doesn't look good. But then on the ground, Ukraine has been so effective at killing dozens and dozens and dozens of Russians, who are attempting to get closer into the city. It seems like the closer to the center of the city, the harder it takes to actually make any progress whatsoever. They've used this opportunity to kill an unbelievable amount of Russian troops, and Russia just keeps throwing more resources in there. Clearly Ukrainian leadership has a better idea of what, you know, of how to maintain battlefield control than we do. But goddamn, they are so fucking close there's only two roads into Bakhmut, and the Russians are within artillery range of both of them. It's a really, really tough thing to predict. If they would have listened to me, they would have been out of there 3 weeks ago. Zerkio. Yeah, I mean, it's they're fighting every battle like it's Stalingrad. You know, they're just throwing as many human beings into it as possible. Yeah, Pergozin is speaking modestly. What is left of Wagner? Yeah, Woke Patriot, exactly. They're going to need that air support if they are going to go in that direction, if they're going to go towards Melitopol, because there's thousands of dug-in Russian troops ready for this fight, fully equipped as well. They're not going to be... They might be running up against that terrible Russian morale, but those guys will have... They will have bullets in their guns. Russian MFA... So this is... You know, you got to look out for this stuff. If you've seen this screenshot, if you've seen this clip here, it has been proven that this is fake. So, you know, probably Aaron Mate and Glenn Greenwald and all those Russian fucking supporters were, you know, probably using Ukraine's really bad. Ukraine's a bunch of Nazis. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, buddy. All right, someone doesn't like getting their ass kicked. I don't really have time to really, you know, participate in these bad actor debates today, guys. I kind of want to get shit done, so I'm just going to be banning these people immediately. I don't really have time for them. Sorry if you want to have some kind of debate with them. Proven by Bellingcat, I think. Even Russian Telegrams with 500,000 followers admit that the video is fake. Yeah, so Russian MFA deleted their tweet. So they actually deleted their tweet. Since it has more numerous problems to grind in Ukraine. Yeah, that's what they think. That's what they think. But I mean, we're already seeing like defections happening at some of these places. I think, you know, if this offensive is successful, it will be another major hit to Russian morale. Ukraine effectively collapsed and the Russians are using airplanes for more bombing support. Ukrainian defense, air defense, you know, actual, like, their planes in the air has always been pretty sparse. And they've only just recently started to receive a couple extra airplanes from America. So that wouldn't surprise me if they don't really have a lot of fighter jets in the air. They don't have a lot of pilots. They don't have a lot of fighter jets. I think they have a lot of pilots, actually. I remember Dennis saying that he was complaining actually about how Ukraine is, you know, someone who has like piloting experience or experience in one way or the other, but they're like, no, we're going to send you to the front lines because that's where we need you. We don't need pilots right now. We don't have a plane to put you in. And Dennis was complaining about that, right? He's like, well, we have a lot of talented people that are not being used to their full talents. France trying to buy 30 jets for Ukraine. None of it's going to get there for this spring offensive or whatever the fuck they want to call this. So yeah, I think it's fair to say that, you know, the Russian fighter jets will be dominating the sky. But they, you know, the Ukrainian man pads and other air defenses are in place. They've received massive influx of air of like really advanced anti-air weapons of various kinds from the Western Alliance. So they are ready. They are ready for the helicopters and fighter jets that will be flying low for these bombing runs. And Russia knows that. You may remember this video from February when Russia Zubarev of the 92nd Mechanized Brigade took part in an intense trench battle. He and his partner eliminated four invaders and an armored personnel carrier. Today, Ruslan was awarded the Golden Cross. Man, they should have gave the homie something too. You're telling me homie in there who's like throwing them ammo and, you know, keeping them loaded and, you know, reloading magazines, he doesn't get the Golden Cross as well? This motherfucker, he might, you know, he was even trying to peek out and help, and the guy was telling him, get your ass back in there and give me, you know, support me. Right? So if you don't know this video, I mean, everyone knows this video. This guy is the motherfucking true badass. This is what the Russians are up against, right? True fucking badass who was actually able to take out how many? Four invaders and an APC. Because we see him fire off this fucking rocket. And then he switches to like two or three different guns. The guy's an absolute badass. Just look at this. This is just unbelievable. It's unbelievable. It's unbelievable. If I was Russian seeing this video, I'd be hanging up my white flag. I'd be hanging out the white handkerchief to the next drone I see. I mean, come on. What are you going to do? I can't show this video as dead people? No. All right. I know what parts will show the dead people, so I'll get it ready. Yeah, takes out. So that was, he took out the APC there. Oh, yeah, can't show that. Yep, takes him out. Yep. Yep, took him out. Okay, I can show the rest. Oh, nope, finishes him off. Can't show that. There we go, I can show that. Cover fire. Yeah, so that's when he says, give me the American grenade. He tells him, he goes, give me the American. And he tosses him a fucking American-style frag grenade. Chucking them bad boys out. Saved it for a special event. Get fucked. Jesus fucking Christ, man. They both got medals? Okay, good. Holy shit, dude. Holy fucking shit. Holy fucking shit. I'm glad they both got medals. They absolutely both deserve medals. You know, I mean, this it wouldn't have worked. He would, the magic wouldn't have been there without this guy in the hole setting him up and getting him ready. Hell yeah, dude. Hell yeah. If I was a Russian general, God forbid, I'd let the UA push a long, skinny salient towards Melitopol and then cut it from both sides. Sure, that would be smart, right? To do a feint, let him overextend and then pinch him off. I mean, Russia has tried that. They do keep trying encirclement tactics, but they can't seal the deal. You know, they just can't seal the deal because what they do is they do these pushes, and then the Russian logistics, the whole Russian military kind of expects a break, a pause, right, to make this progress. And then, okay, we get a day to, you know, to settle in. The Ukrainians, they'll take steps back, as many steps as they need to take. And then the moment the Russian push loses momentum, they hit, forcing those Russians who are exhausted and desperately needing supplies to push back. We've seen it time and time again. Even when Russia took advantageous terrain, when they had the higher ground in the north of Bakhmut, they had that higher ground there. They took that area. Ukraine was still able to push them back. So Russians continue to build fences and trenches along the occupied beaches of the Black Sea coast. This is in Severodonetsk. Oh my goodness. Thank you. Right. Thank you, honey. Yeah. You want to take a kiddo? All right. Oh, titty milk time. What a lucky boy. What a lucky boy. Here you go, honey. I want the best in that. Put him in the back. So he can see. So this is funny. So the Russians continue to build fences and trenches along the occupied beaches of the Black Sea coast. This is Skadovsk. I'm not quite sure. I'm sure I'm saying that wrong. The Russian desperation is in full display. So I said in the Discord, I was like, so these fences are being built to hold, to keep the Ukrainians out. These fences could easily be used to hold the Russians in, right? They think they're going to be... Marta. I mean, what are these gonna even do, man? This is like a 4 to 5 second inconvenience. They it's not like they have machine gun nests set up like, you know, like World War II beaches. You know, they don't have the big fortified machine gun nest set up. It's like what just yeah, a display of Russian corruption. Right? Oh, we did it. We solved. We got you all. We're all barricaded, and the beach is all safe, boss. Thanks for the millions of dollars for the proper defenses. We put up the most expensive and well built defenses we could afford, boss. It's a mild inconvenience at best.
by yourself.
That's a big L. This is something you would set up for a concert, for like a music concert on the beach. Can't imagine a big beach landing from UA. Maybe just incurious. No, I don't see that happening either. Not without a much bigger Navy. You know, you need to do something really big. But I mean, who knows? I mean, I do think what we are going to see is some kind of feint. I think because everyone knows this is happening, I think they're gonna make a move, and then a week later they're gonna make a different move. That's my opinion on it. Maybe my backyard fence is stronger than that. No, yeah, probably actually, yeah, probably because it's staked in properly. If Russia is afraid of so this is interesting to me because you know, the old school fellas in the chat will remember a time when the United States was ashamed to admit that they were using depleted uranium in Iraq. I mean, there was a big scandal, right, in Iraq or Afghanistan, one of those. Oh, is the U.S. using depleted uranium? Is the U.S. using depleted uranium? And now that we're the good guys in this narrative, quote from John Kirby here, quote, if Russia is afraid of depleted uranium projectiles, they can withdraw their tanks from Ukraine. This is my recommendation to them. It's just very interesting to see such blunt honesty from the military-industrial complex of the United States, because they tiptoe around depleted uranium. Oh, we didn't use it. What's that? We've never even heard of it. Like, look up the clips from the Bush era wars about depleted uranium, and you'll see a bunch of coy. I don't know. I've never even heard of this. I don't know. What's this? It's also going to be well planned. Yeah, I agree, Clutch Cargo. Russian style, always a fair share of steel in anything they do. This is concern called corruption is mega present in Eastern Europe countries as well. Yeah, no doubt. Yeah, I mean that, you know, Russia, I mean, I just watched this really great summary of, you know, the entire start of the war and kind of where we're at now. And, you know, that convoy that they sent, you know, from Belarus, it only took 3 days for large chunks of the convoy to experience major mechanical failures because none of this stuff was upkept. You know, it was just that money was put in a pocket somewhere and some guy got rich. And then Putin, apparently out of the blue, I didn't know this, is that he didn't even consult with a big chunk of his, you know, of his government about doing this. So, like, even people super high up in the government, you think, you know, the troops on the ground, they thought they were going to a training session. But even the higher-ups close to Putin were like, whoa, what the fuck is going on? What are we doing? Oh, I guess we're doing it now. So I'm going to show some military mind here. It's always a blast. Military mind by TVP, which is right-wing Polish. Pro-right-wing Polish government, but you know they have no problem telling the truth about what's happening in Ukraine and Russia, right? But it gives me RT vibes. It gives me RT vibes because RT used to report on it. They would be happy to tell you the truth if it had anything to do with the United States. They would, you know, do great reporting, pay for great reporters, you know, present news in a very unbiased way, right? Unless we're talking about Russia or anything that has to do with Russia, then it was like rah, rah, rah cheerleading. It was really, really weird. They'd have Jesse Ventura talking about, you know, the dangers of the police, you know, police militarization, how disgusting it is. And then, you know, then some kind of puff piece about how great Moscow is. RT was really quite trippy. And TVP world is in that same vein, right? As long if it's not about Poland or if it makes Poland looks good, we'll tell you the truth, no problem.
SVK rifle, a 12.7
mil. When will I be monetized? Never. If you wanna help the stream, I do sell some merch, but I really do encourage you to donate your money to a progressive organization that you like. You know, that's the best way to support the stream is to participate in political activism. That's what helps the stream the most.
Millimeter heavy sniper platform picked up from a dead Russian soldier.
Oh shit, they're using a sniper rifle. Oh my god, look at this. They got VHS tapes, man. You're in someone's house, dude. Get out of their house. These are Ukrainians, right? But it's just like, I can't believe Russia did this, man. They have no choice but to invade someone, you know? It just sucks. But they gotta do what they gotta do. They're doing their job. And unlike the Russians, they don't fucking, you know, they don't try to fuck everything up. Oh my God, is that a Barrett? What the fuck is that, dude?
Earlier this week, Ukraine's defense...
He didn't confirm the hit. I wonder what he was shooting at. So they picked this weapon up from a Russian. And then he gets the hell out of there. That's really interesting. All right, let's see here. Let's go to the next video. We don't need the presentation.
Of them should be operating at the front.
Some Challengers in there. Nice. Love to see it. Every little bit helps.
Marvelous. Ben, Secretary of Defense.
These guys that are used to Soviet tanks, they're used to these cramped fucking death machines, these fucking metal coffins on tracks. And they get into these newer tanks, and they're like, oh man, this is great. I don't even need a hammer to change gears. Oh, I got all the room in the world. these Soviet era tanks are death coffins, okay? I wouldn't trust them. Okay. I lost some frames there, so sorry if there's some skipping.
United Kingdom. It's a very good stop. Thank you very much from Ukraine to United Kingdom.
Tearing ass. Well, don't, you know, the Western countries really need to stop patting themselves on the back, because they really need to send way more. A couple hundred tanks total, you know, from everybody. Even though they're very good tanks, it's not enough. It's not enough. My internet has taken a little bit of a dump here, guys. So if I drop some frames, that's why. But it's not enough. The tip is in. Okay, you're doing this just the tip game. I agree with Davey by this time. Like, what are we waiting for? What the fuck are we even flirting around with? Send them in. Go, go, go. Okay? More, more, more. They're trained. They're ready to go. We got the logistics taken care of. Maybe not for the Abrams, but for the fucking Leopards and the Challengers. Let's go. What the fuck are we waiting for? My opinion of the war is that we need to get this done. Push Russia back to its borders. Spank its little ass. And then go back to business as usual. You know, this hammer and sickle fear mongering about Ukraine invading Russia or NATO invading Russia is fucking bullpucky. Okay? Ain't no one invading Russia. Not unless they drop a nuke. Then that changes everything. What is going on with my internet? And this is hardcore propaganda, okay? Can we... The music. It will, but they need more of them. Man, I'm dropping hella frames, bro. My internet. We need more of them. That one Russian group invaded Bryansk.
Ukrainian.
Okay, let's get to the next clip here. Can I show this one? I can't show this one because they're dropping grenades on people. Can't show you people getting shredded, but I can show you an airstrike from above. I mean, it's so nasty when you see these artillery strikes, because it, you know, like, look at the look at the scattering, like all the different, because those are particles hitting the dirt. That just gives you an idea of just the radius, right? It doesn't need to be a direct hit to cause a lot of damage. See, all that right around there, those were all metal particles flying in all directions. Nasty shit. Artillery is the thing that's killing the most people on the battlefield right now. Really nasty shit. And it's totally like going up against it must be actually maddening, because what do you do? You can't, all you can do is jump in a hole and pray to Allah.
Be the first documented loss of a Russian electronic warfare asset.
Like a Chechen.
Now hold your breath and count to 10.
Okay, that is definitely going to get me DMCA'd. But look at that, dude. You see these particles? Look how fucking far they're out. Nasty. Nasty shit. Jesus Christ. You got stuff hitting way over here. Can't do the licensed music. I'm not one of those streamers that can do licensed music and then just not get in trouble for it. I don't know how they do this. The Russian volunteer corps that are fighting for Ukraine went inside Russian territory. Oh, interesting. I mean, that's not an invasion. I know that you put invasion in quotes there. Yeah, Chem Goblin, how is everything over there in Ukraine? Are you doing all right? There you go. That was military. A little bit of military mind. I love military minds. A lot of fun. It's fun how it's weird. It's like Orwellian fun, because it's like they're so happy to report on the carnage of the battlefield. Looks like right here. So the video says he's in a trench alone, but there actually does appear to be someone over here. He does interact with somebody over here, but he's close enough. Russians are getting close enough to his trench to where I think he's shooting at people that are very visible. And I've shown footage of this last weekend of like a field just filled with like 50 Russian soldiers coming in. I think that's what we're seeing here. This is what it looks like to be inside the trench defending against that. Chem Goblin, I'm glad to hear that you're safe. Good luck with your legal issues. That sucks, man. Yeah, so he's got someone right next to him firing away. He's reloading his grenade launcher right here. He's putting a grenade into each little tube. Ooh, and these are nasty. Ooh. Oh, you can hear them. Okay. All right, that's all we got. Dumps it out. But they're too close to take the time to reload this. I think. Or no? Does he reload it a second time? Yeah, looks like he's reloading it a second time. Maybe he reloads it, but then he picks up the rifle. Reloads it and saves it for later in case they get close. Nope. Okay, he sends out another salvo. Ooh, he's cutting it close. Those guys are close. Yep, out of ammo. They're too close now. He's got to bust the rifle out. I did not watch this. I guess I skipped to the end of this clip. I didn't know he did. Okay, there he goes. Yeah, all right. Yep. Business time. They're coming. They're storming. You know, because that's what Russia will do. They'll build the 20, 30, 40 troops. Right. And then they'll storm a position of 3 to 4 Ukrainians in a trench. We showed the, actually I wasn't able to show that because of the, all the death that was in that footage, but in the Discord, I posted a full breakdown of that battle. And it was interesting because in that battle I was showing, that was the one with the amazing artillery hit that takes out like 8 Russian soldiers at once. But the tank going through the tree line and shooting at the Russians that are running along the road, that was part of the same clip. I did not know that. But they're coming. Dozens of Russians potentially storming their location. You know? Also notice no grenades, no artillery. Right, these guys, it's just a bunch of, you know, Russian troops with rifles. No tanks shooting against the Ukrainians. Where's the artillery support? Where's the coordination? Yeah, I mean, that's how you feel, Rob. Imagine how these Ukrainians feel. This is the 9-to-5 right here. This is what it looks like. Clack clack, man. So this is interesting because he's doing single shot, but then to empty his mag, he switches to full auto real quick. Is that some kind of burst or full auto? Something like that. Trench fighting from the Russian side? Okay, we'll show it. I bet you in that video we're going to see more coordination, more grenades, more artillery. Oh, AKs don't have burst modes. They just have full auto and single shot. Yeah, so I bet. So Davey's got a great clip here of what it looks like to be a Russian defending against a Ukrainian push. And I'm hoping what we will see is more coordination. Because you don't just send troops in, right? If you're going to do a push against a trench, you send troops in along with, you know, you get them as close as possible with an APC. You start throwing as much artillery as you possibly can on those targets. Hopefully you have it, right? You maybe some suicide drones, maybe some drones dropping grenades. Like, you want to coordinate these things at the same time to help confuse the enemy, to make it harder for them to defend the trench. You don't just send Russians in, you know, you don't just send people in a wave coming from one direction, and then just cross your fingers and hope for the best. So here we have Russians right here defending their trench. I mean, it literally looks like, is this, it's World War One, man. Fuck, dude. All right, so that was coming from Russia. What is this guy doing? Okay, I know. Okay, yes. Okay, so yeah, I know. I've seen this clip before. I know this. The video quality is really bad. So this guy, he's doing that to his head because he was a bullet hit his helmet, and he was just saved by his helmet. So this guy right here, man, the quality. The video I saw was much better quality. Let me see if this. Does anyone have a better quality one? No, they don't. Boom. So right there. Oh, it is really loud. Sorry. So right there, he actually, his helmet gets hit with a bullet right there. One more time. So he's taking up a position right here. He's about to fire. Boom. Right there. Helmet. Yeah, pretty scary stuff. That's, you know, if you've seen Saving Private Ryan, there's that, you know, really amazing scene where the guy, he bullet pings off his helmet and he stands up. He's all surprised. Oh, look what happened, guys. And then another bullet goes right in his head because he stood up. Yeah, that really didn't show the coordination that I was trying to describe, but that was a really good clip. Thank you, Davey. Members of the Ukrainian 90, I didn't know that was Russia, by the way. I thought that was Ukrainian. So hard to tell. Members of the Ukrainian 93rd Mechanized Brigade booby trap. So this, I was talking about this months ago because I saw, you know, I've been watching a lot of World War II stuff, watching how, you know, Russians fought their wars in the past. And, amazingly, I think it was when, was it Stalingrad or was it was the city? It was the city before Stalingrad, that the Russians booby trapped and, Russians were dark green. So this is ironic to me because here we have the Ukrainians booby trapping, you know, a building that they suspected that Ukrainians would go into. And this is what happened. You know, I don't know how many Russians went into that building, but yeah, apparently they had it triggered up with mines or something. Nasty explosion. Ironically, the Russians did this to the Germans when they were invading one of their major cities. I don't remember specifically which one. But yeah, look how nasty that one is. Clearly something in the somewhere in the basement or something. Nasty ass shit. This is the most popular brigade. These guys, I haven't seen this logo too much. I thought Kraken was the most popular. How does Freddie Dredd feel about his fucking music and samples being used in this war footage? That's gotta be a weird feeling for Freddie Dredd. First, all of his music is being used for fucking TikTok fucking songs, and now his music's being used for Ukrainian war footage. Line cut. I think I've heard of these rifles that are capable of doing that. I've never seen them in action. Is Israel actually using those special rifles that can shoot around corners in the field? So here's that footage of, I think this was provided by Davey, but here's that footage of, you know, just a small smattering, small congregation of Russian armor and, you know, troops getting ready for the big fucking show. Thank you, Geriatric Richard. Those are two fingers? Are those fingers? That is an ass. Wow. How did Geriatric Richard get away with that? He's all flashing ass on his motherfucking avatar. Just a small. Getting ready for the big fucking show, y'all. Yeah, I thought Geriatric Richard just had like a cheeky photo of like someone using their fingers to look like a butt crack. But no, that's ass. That's ass over there. Check it. Geriatric Richard, he's an ass man. Footage that I think I will put this in the category of footage that is guaranteed to be used, that is guaranteed to be mimicked in the war movies that we see about Ukraine. Nope, that's it, Kim Goblin. We're just doing a quick one here, a special presentation on gun violence, and, you know, figured I'd cap it off with Ukraine. It's an interesting juxtaposition, right? You know, seeing all the tragic gun violence in America against children and then cheering on gun violence against invading troops. I understand it's a dichotomy, but this is the world we live in. It's not simply black and white, is it? I absolutely support Ukraine defending itself to the fullest. And yes, that includes using military weapons. I then disagree with the dissemination and use of military weapons in a civilian setting in the United States. A bad actor would look at those two and say those two things are the same. But someone with nuance who's actually willing to, you know, understand the reality of the situation would understand that it's a tragic dichotomy, that, you know, I have to root on violence to defend oneself because of tyrants and authoritarians. And then I also have to fight very similar violence, but different violence in my own hometown, in my own city, in my own school, in my own Capitol Hill, you know. But I classify this footage as footage guaranteed we're going to be seeing recreated in a movie about Ukraine. Guaranteed. This is a firefight inside of a ship's own figure of the way, so skim. Okay, this is a gunfight in a... You think they'll just use this song as well? This is a gunfight in a cemetery. Yeah, maybe they'll just use this song as well. Why not? Yeah, look at that. So they're gunfight in the fucking cemetery. This song is, this is like Godsmack from the early 2000s. Is this orgy? Is this orgy, Godsmack, or Disturbed? Is this Creed? Remember Creed? Oh, what happened? Oh, then the music just stops. They really need to stop with the licensed music, because it makes it really easy to slow down the dissemination of these clips. If, you know, if you use licensed music, it'll get fucking flagged and then removed. Stop using licensed music in your combat footage, dum-dums. Please. And if you're going to use licensed music, don't use corny-ass music. Stop using corny-ass music. Yeah, I didn't... thank you, Davey. I did not have this one queued up. I should have. This was posted recently in the Discord, but first-person footage inside a Ukrainian fighter jet, kicking some ass. No audio here. Damn! Oh, shit! Oh, shit! Fuck, that is so low to the goddamn ground, bro. Holy shit, dude. Is that him receiving, what, return fire? Is he in a dogfight? Holy nutsack, dude. That is way too fucking close to the ground. Yeah, so he tips it up, fires him off, fires the salvo off. So they do that. I learned recently that they do that whole, you know, tipping the plane up and shooting off a shitload of missiles, so that they can stay out of the anti-air range of the Russians or the Ukrainians. Both sides have been doing this. Dude, you are too fucking close, man. Look at you, too close, my close. Okay, I don't think he's. I'm not sure. I'm not sure if he's getting chased or something, or this is just normal behavior. Look at the old Soviet cockpit too. All analog dials, nothing digital. Look at that. Look at this. This is like some kind of maybe proximity sensor. This would tell him if something. It's just like an engine light, dude. It's like a fucking it's like a low oil indicator, man. This shit is so low tech. Low ass tech. Look at the gauges and dials on that thing. Damn, dude, that's right out of the 80s, man. Yeah, they're doing what they can with what they got. Okay, actually, so it looks like I did have it queued up. I think this is the higher quality video of the bullet flinging off the guy's helmet. No, it looks like it's the same quality. Yeah, shit quality. Pretty wild shit, though. Bing, right there, you see it. He's like, did it penetrate? Did it penetrate? Did it penetrate? Wow. Lucky, dude. Lucky. It's not very, I mean, it, you know, most of the rifle bullets are able to penetrate their helmets. So it's, you know, it's gotta be, you know, you're super lucky for that to happen. Their rifle bullets can penetrate these helmets. Super fucking lucky. All right, and the final clip I have for you today, rare footage of the Ukrainian 152mm 2S5 Hyacinth, which I thought was funny because I'm a big fan of the fucking show with Hyacinth and Keeping Up Appearances. I'm a big fan of that show. So this is the Hyacinth howitzer firing on Russian troops outside of Bakhmut. I just picture, her pushing the button going, "It's bouquet!" And then hitting the button, right? "It's not bucket, it's bouquet." And they should have played the keeping up appearances theme. No, hold on. I'm going to make this combat footage much better. Hold on. All right, we're going to make this combat footage better. They don't even know what they're doing over there. Theme, there we go. Here we go.
It's bouquet. I'll call you on my slimline telephone. Richard? Load up another shell, Richard!
Hell yeah. There you go, folks. That's my special presentation for today. You know, Clutch Cargo, that's an interesting question. Look at you with a very philosophical and interesting question. I think war is a placebo for that. War emulates that feeling. Thank you, Lenny, very much. But Clutch Cargo, what you're saying is that, yeah, it feels like it gives you meaning. But it is in it, if allowed to go unchecked, which it often wants to, war, it will destroy humanity. But it feels like it gives you meaning. It feels like it gives you a purpose. So it's a placebo to the elimination of nihilism. It's dangerous because it's like, it's like drinking alcohol almost, where it's like you feel like this is the solution. And then it gets you deeper and deeper and deeper into it. And Chem Goblin, I totally agree with you. Well, thank you, Clutch Cargo. There you go, YouTube. That's my Ukrainian update for today. We'll be doing more on Saturday, maybe Sunday. We'll see. Sometimes I'm too tired on Saturday with the kid here. But we'll do another big 5 to 6 hour stream on Saturday. So please check out the Twitch, like and subscribe. Greatly appreciate it. We have a lot of fun here, even though a lot of the stuff we talk about is not so fun. Thank you.